Okay, well, I took ayahuasca for the first time at the end of October 2011, and I think you might have been involved. So it was my first experience with ayahuasca, apparently garnered from Peru, made by shamans in Peru. I think again you might have been involved in sequestering that ayahuasca, but I'm not one to gossip. And we took the ayahuasca in a very nice Welsh forest in Snowdonia, a remote forest. We'd climbed Cadair Idris that day, so we were physically quite tired when we took the ayahuasca, which is quite good because I think we were very relaxed. We took it around a fire in this lovely campsite in Snowdonia, in which you performed a ceremony that I appreciated. And it was my first time I've experienced psilocybin hundreds of times. It was my first experience with ayahuasca, so it was quite illuminating. And I could say a lot about that night's events, the experiences was quite profound. But one of the things that struck me the most about the experience was, because I was quite intimidated at the time, but I had stacks and stacks of experience with psilocybin, but ayahuasca's got a very unique mythos attached to it, so it was I was quite apprehensive. But I found that it took me to the same place as psilocybin, which was very interesting. It was almost a relief, really. It took me to the same realm. It's the same higher self that is potentiated and catalyzed and that emerges. And so I recognized it, and it was very almost indistinguishable. The visual, the visionary side of it was, I found for me, was almost indistinguishable from psilocybin, which I found fascinating. It took me to the same realm. It's the same higher self, and I recognized it. And I guess it was a very intense experience. It was a very intense, as you can remember, it was a very intense night, evening. I think we both were very inspired by it. At one point, I just felt that there was a very ancient wisdom, was that we were like two old men sat there around this fire, sort of our heads nodding. And that there was this very powerful, we were a channel for some very, very powerful ancient wisdom. I really had that. It was a very strong impression. It was very intense. And I guess the peak or the thing I remember the most about the experience was, it was shortly after this feeling of this very ancient, that we were channeling or conveying this ancient wisdom that is normally flows in Peru and in the Amazon. I felt was flowing through, we were a channel for it in Snowdonia, so it felt very auspicious that this ayahuasca was in psilocybin country, because we picked psilocybin mushrooms a few days later. So it seemed very auspicious, and some ancient kind of wisdom was there. And the thing I remember the most was, at some stage and it seemed to last ages. I don't know if it did last ages, but I shut my eyes, and I had a vision, but it was more of a voice, and it was an American Indian, like an American, I see it as an archetype, and this American Indian archetype emerged within my psyche, like an American Indian, an elder, American Indian, North American Indian chief or elder. And it seemed very auspicious and momentous, and it was like he was addressing the world and it was all like in slow motion, and he was addressing the world, and he had this message for the world. And he said it was so simple, but almost absurdly simple. he said his message to the world was the earth is our mother. That was the that was this kind of message from this American Indian archetype. The earth is our mother, and it just seemed very profound at the time. And then later, when we were discussing it hours later, I said it seemed quite it seems so simple, that notion the earth is our mother. I remember saying to you in an excited way, I said, but if I was to write an essay about that experience, I'd be able to defend it. I mean, what does mother mean? What does the earth really mean? And I can sort of, that seemingly simple statement or assertion, the earth is our mother, I could defend it. I could use science and philosophy, and I could sort of flesh it out and really defend it. And you said to me, well, no, you don't need it. It's fine on its own. You don't need to, which I thought was quite interesting. But that was a very powerful experience for me, because there was an American Indian chief there. I heard his voice, and he delivered that message, and it just seemed very poignant and very powerful. So that was probably the one of the highlights of that ayahuasca experience, which is maybe quite unusual. I don't know, but there you go. That's what happened.
Mm-hmm. All right. Good.